Now, the next scientist who classified the element was a Russian scientist, and his name was. His name was Dmitry Mendeleev. Now, he developed a periodic table during the period of. Period of 1869 to 1872 AD. Now, during his time, 63 elements were known. He first arranged all the elements by in increasing order of their atomic mass. So first he arranged all the elements on the basis of what? Increasing order of their atomic mass. And then he developed a table. And then he developed a periodic table. On the basis of physical and chemical properties of the elements. He considered molecular formula. Molecular formula of hydrides of elements. Then molecular formula. Of oxides of element, melting point of the elements, boiling points of the element. Of the elements and density of the elements. And he was able to prepare a periodic table. So the previous scientist concentrated only on the atomic mass, and Mendeleev concentrated in the atomic mass also, as well as on the physical and the chemical properties. Which all physical and chemical property? Molecular formula of hydrides of element, molecular formula of oxides of element, melting point of the element, boiling point of the element, and densities of the element. तो जो अगला साइंटिस्ट जो क्लासिफाई किया एलिमेंट्स को वो एक रशियन साइंटिस्ट था, उसका नाम था डिमिट्री मेंडलेव. और उसने एक पीरियडिक टेबल बनाया, कौन सा पीरियड में? 1869 से लेके 1872 AD तक. उसके टाइम में 63 एलिमेंट्स पता था, और उसने भी पहले सब एलिमेंट्स को इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ एटॉमिक मास, जैसे जैसे एटॉमिक मास बढ़ते गया उसी ऑर्डर से उसने अरेंज किया. एंड ही डेवलप्ड अ पीरियडिक टेबल, और उसने फिर पीरियडिक टेबल बनाया. पहले उसने सब एलिमेंट्स को अरेंज किया एटॉमिक मास, इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ एटॉमिक मास के हिसाब से. फिर उसने केमिकल और फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज़ के बेसिस में पीरियडिक टेबल बनाया, जैसे कि कौन सा प्रॉपर्टीज, मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला ऑफ हाइड्राइड्स ऑफ एलिमेंट, मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला ऑफ ऑक्साइड्स ऑफ एलिमेंट, मेल्टिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द एलिमेंट, बॉइलिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द एलिमेंट, एंड डेंसिटीज ऑफ द एलिमेंट. बाय ऑब्जर्विंग दिस पीरियडिक टेबल ही स्टेटेड द पीरियडिक लॉ. What is a periodic law? That properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic mass. Now the table which I have drawn on the board is a periodic table prepared by Mendeleev. What did he do? He made separate cards for each element and wrote their atomic mass on that card, and then he arranged the cards or the elements on the basis of their atomic mass as well as their properties. And this way he was able to develop this periodic table. Now he called this vertical columns. The vertical columns were known as what? Vertical columns. Were known as group, and the horizontal rows were known as what? This way, horizontal rows were known as period. From this table, he observed that every element with same chemical properties repeat after a definite interval. Now, if you can see, I had told just now that he had prepared the table on the basis of the properties. Now, whatever I have written in red color are the molecular formulas of the oxides of the element, and whatever I have written on the blue are the molecular formula of the hydrides of this element. For example, here it is given R2O, then I'll take this R2O3, then this one RH4, let us take RH4. So these are the molecular formulas of oxides. These two are the oxide and this is of hydride. But today, at present, we don't write the molecular formula this way. We write the molecular formula as this way, R2O, R2O3 and RH4. Now what is this R? R is an element on that particular period and group. So R is an element and O is an oxide and H is a hydride of that particular element. Now let us take R2O. Now we will take H. So in place of R, we will write down H. So what is the molecular formula of the oxide of the hydrogen? H2O. Now let us take one, this aluminium. Aluminium can be written in place of R, you will write down aluminium, Al2O3. So this is oxide of aluminium. Now let us take RH4. We will take carbon. So in place of R, I'll write C, and hydride will be what? CH4. So you have studied all this molecular formula. This is of water. This is of aluminium oxide. This is methane. So the molecular formula of methane is what? CH4. So this way he was able to prepare the periodic table. अभी मेंडेलीव जो था उसने क्या किया, हर एक एलिमेंट्स को एक सेपरेट कार्ड में एलिमेंट का नाम लिखा और उसका एटॉमिक मास लिखा, और फिर एटॉमिक मास और प्रॉपर्टीज़ के बेसिस में उसने ये पीरियोडिक टेबल बनाया. अब मैंने सिर्फ आधा ही बताया पीरियोडिक टेबल. पेज नंबर 18 में है पीरियोडिक टेबल ऑफ मेंडल, प्रिपेयर्ड बाय मेंडेलीव. उसने देखा कि हर एलिमेंट जिसका प्रॉपर्टीज़ एकदम सेम है वो डेफिनेट इंटरवल के बाद वो वापस रिपीट होता है. उसने ये टेबल में ये वर्टिकल कॉलम्स को क्या नाम दिया? ग्रुप. और हॉरिजॉन्टल रोज को क्या नाम दिया? पीरियड. अभी मैं ऊपर जो लिखा हुआ है रेड कलर में वो मॉलिकुलर फॉर्मूला ऑफ ऑक्साइड है, और जो ब्लू में लिखा हुआ है वो मॉलिकुलर फॉर्मूला ऑफ हाइड्राइड्स एलिमेंट्स का, मॉलिकुलर फॉर्मूला ऑफ हाइड्राइड्स ऑफ एलिमेंट एंड मॉलिकुलर फॉर्मूला ऑफ ऑक्साइड्स ऑफ एलिमेंट. अभी समझो मैंने ये लिया R2O, R2O3, RH4, ये तीन लिया है. तो उस ज़माने में जो टू जो ये ऊपर लिखा जाता था, लेकिन आज प्रेजेंट में अपन ऊपर नहीं लिखते, नीचे लिखते हैं. तो इसको कैसे लिखते हैं अभी? R2O. इसको कैसे लिखते हैं? R2O3. और ये ऐसा लिखा जाता है RH4. और ये R क्या है? एलिमेंट्स का नाम. जैसा अगर मैंने R2O का फर्स्ट एलिमेंट H लिया, तो R के जगह में H डालो तो क्या मिलता है? H2O. अभी नेक्स्ट वाला एलुमिनियम लिया मैंने, एलुमिनियम R2O3 है, तो ऑक्साइड ऑफ एलुमिनियम क्या रहेगा? R के जगह में Al लिखने का, तो Al2O3, तो Al2O3. RH4 में अगर मैंने कार्बन लिया तो R के जगह में C लिखा जाएगा, तो CH4. और ये सब पढ़ चुका है पिछले साल. ये वाटर है, ये एलुमिनियम ऑक्साइड है, और ये मीथेन है. Now on page 19 on the top, there is one question. There are some vacant places in the Mendeleev's periodic table. In some of these places, the atomic masses are seen to be predicted. Enlist three of this predicted atomic mass along with their group and period. So during Mendeleev's time, only 63 elements were known. But while arranging, he found out the atomic mass of the next. After calcium, he found out the atomic mass of that element. But in those days, that element was not yet discovered. But he had found it, he had predicted the atomic mass of that element. So in this, one of the element is atomic mass is what? 44. Here nothing is written. So it is 44. The next one is over here, 68. And the next one is over here, 72. Now you have to write down the group and period. Now how to write down the group? Now over here, 44. 44 comes under which group? Group 3. So it is what? Group 3. And what is the period? Here, period is what? 4. 4 is a period. So period is 4. Same way the next one, 68. Which group it is coming? 3. Group 3. And what is the period? Period is what? 5. 5 is the period. So period is 5. Next one, 72. 72, what is a group over here? 4. 4 is a group. And what's the period? Period is what? 72. That is 5. So period is 5. There are many of them. You can write any three of them. Now on the same page, page number 19, the next question is, due to the uncertainty in the names of some of the elements, a question mark is indicated. Over here you can see a question mark is indicated. He was not sure about the element, so he has put a question mark before the symbol in the Mendeleev's periodic table. What are such symbols? So one of them you can see over here, that is YT. The other ones you can see below this, which I have not drawn over here, that is DI, CE, ER and LA. So these elements were not known during his time, but yet he predicted the atomic mass of these elements and the properties of these elements also. Now what is the merits of Mendeleev periodic table? When Mendeleev prepared this table, he had to change the atomic mass of certain element, for example beryllium. Before he made this table, the atomic mass of beryllium was how much? 14.09. Later when he arranged the elements according to their properties and properties, he found that the atomic mass of beryllium should be how much? 9.4. Hence in his table he placed beryllium before boron. Second important thing is what he found. You can see these empty spaces. These are the elements which was not discovered during the time of Mendeleev, but yet Mendeleev was able to predict the atomic mass of these elements as well as the properties of these elements. And he named this element as what? Eka boron. Eka boron. This was known as Eka aluminium, and this was known as Eka silicon. So Eka boron, Eka aluminium, and Eka silicon. And later when this element was discovered, it was named as what? Scandium, gallium, and germanium. And when this element was discovered, they found that the properties and the atomic mass of these elements was matching with the properties and the atomic mass predicted by Mendeleev. That is why the scientists at those time understood the importance of this periodic table and they accepted it. The third important thing was what? In 19th century, noble gas was discovered. What are noble gas? Like helium, neon, argon, etc. So these are the noble gas. It was just not mentioned in this table. So he prepared a separate group for those elements and named that group as zero group, and he placed helium, neon, argon in that particular group without disturbing this table. Now demerits of Mendeleev's periodic table, or what is a fault in the periodic table. First one was that when elements were arranged in the increasing order of the atomic mass, there was no uniformity. There was no uniformity in the appearance of the एटॉमिक मास For example, hydrogen is 1, lithium is 7. So the difference between hydrogen and lithium is vast. Now when you compare lithium and beryllium, it is hardly 2.6, 2.4. Between beryllium and boron, it is hardly 1.6. Over here, it is 1. So atomic mass did not appear in uniform manner. So they could not predict. They could not predict that how many elements would be discovered between two heavy elements. Now cobalt and nickel. The second one was what? Cobalt and nickel both had same atomic mass. So there was a confusion that how to place this cobalt and nickel, whether to place cobalt before nickel or to place nickel before cobalt. Third, when isotopes were discovered, they had same chemical properties, but different atomic mass. So the atomic mass were different, but the chemical properties were same. So if they had same chemical properties, they should be placed in the same box, but they have different atomic mass, so they should be placed in a different box. So this confusion was also there before the scientist. Now the fourth demerit of Mendeleev's periodic table was what? Hydrogen is in group 1 and halogens are what? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodines are known as halogens, and halogens are in group 7. He found the molecular formula of the group 1 hydrogen and that of the halogens were very similar. For example, the molecular formula of hydrogen is H2, the molecular formula of chlorine is Cl2, the molecular formula of fluorine is F2, the molecular formula of bromine is Br2, and so on. So there was similarity in the property formulas of hydrogen and that of halogens. Similarly, he found that there was a similarity in chemical properties of hydrogen and halogens. Hydrogen combines with sodium to form NaH, and Cl also combines with sodium to form NaCl. Similarly, hydrogen combines with carbon to form CH4, and chlorine also combines with carbon to form CCl4. So he found there was similarity in the hydrogen, which was placed in group 1. Group 1 is also known as alkali metal. So group 1 is known as alkali metal also. So he found there was similarity in a hydrogen, which was in group 1, with that of the halogens. Similarly, he found there is similarity in hydrogen and alkali metals. The metals which are placed in group 1, there was similarity between hydrogen and the alkali metals like sodium and potassium. For example, when hydrogen combines with chlorine, it forms HCl. Similarly, the compounds of sodium, when it combines with Cl, it forms NaCl. Hydrogen, when it combines with oxygen, it forms H2O. And sodium also, when it combines with oxygen, it forms Na2O. Similarly, hydrogen, when it combines with sulfur, it forms H2S. And sodium also combines with sulfur to form Na2S. Same way with potassium also, it will form KCl, K2O and K2S. So since hydrogen showed similarity with the group 1 elements also and with that of the halogen, so there was a confusion where to place hydrogen, in group 1 or in group 7. So halogens is in group 7. Abhi fourth demerit kya hai? कि हाइड्रोजन जो था वो ग्रुप वन में है और हैलोजन्स जो था जैसे कि फ्लोरीन, क्लोरीन, ब्रोमीन, आयोडीन, ये सब ग्रुप सेवन में है। तो इन दोनों का मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला एकदम सेम है, जैसे कि हाइड्रोजन का मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला H2 है, क्लोरीन का मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला Cl2 है, फ्लोरीन का मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला F2 है, ब्रोमीन का मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला Br2 है। वैसे ही हाइड्रोजन और क्लोरीन का केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज़ भी बहुत सिमिलर है, जैसे कि हाइड्रोजन जब भी सोडियम के साथ कंबाइन होता है तो NaH बनता है और क्लोरीन जब सोडियम के साथ कंबाइन होता है तो NaCl बनता है। वैसे ही जब हाइड्रोजन कार्बन के साथ कंबाइन होता है तो उसका मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला CH4 है और क्लोरीन जब कार्बन के साथ कंबाइन होता है तो उसका CCl4 है। अभी ये था सिमिलैरिटी इन ग्रुप वन हाइड्रोजन और हैलोजन, मगर ग्रुप वन हाइड्रोजन जो रहता है वो सिमिलैरिटी ग्रुप वन के साथ भी बताता है, जैसे कि सोडियम और पोटेशियम। ग्रुप वन का नाम अल्कली मेटल्स भी है, जैसे कि हाइड्रोजन जब भी क्लोरीन के साथ कंबाइन होता है तो उसका मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला HCl है, वैसे ही सोडियम जब क्लोरीन के साथ कंबाइन होता है तो उसका मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला NaCl है, हाइड्रोजन जब कंबाइन होता है ऑक्सीजन के साथ तो उसका मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला H2 है और सोडियम ऑक्सीजन के साथ कंबाइन होता है तो उसका मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला Na2a। सिमिलरली सल्फर के साथ हाइड्रोजन क्या मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला क्या है H2S और सोडियम जब भी सल्फर के साथ कंबाइन होता है तो उसका मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला क्या है Na2S। तो उसने देखा कि साइंटिस्ट ने ऑब्जर्व किया कि मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला ऑफ हाइड्रोजन और मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला ऑफ एल्कली मेटल लाइक सोडियम और पोटेशियम, उन दोनों का मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला एकदम सिमिलर है। जो ग्रुप वन है वो एल्कली मेटल है और ग्रुप सेवन जो है वो हैलोजन्स है। तो ये कन्फ्यूशन था कि हाइड्रोजन को कहाँ रखा जाए, ग्रुप वन एल्कली मेटल के साथ रखना है कि ग्रुप सेवन हैलोजन्स के साथ रखना है।